Hello everyone and welcome to this video tutorial on burglary. The offence of burglary is set out in section 9 of the Theft Act 1968 and there are actually two offences of burglary under section 9, burglary under section 91A and burglary under section 91B, and it's really important that you understand the difference between the two. The maximum sentence for burglary is 14 years imprisonment in the case of dwellings and 10 years for all other buildings. There is also an offence of aggravated burglary under section 10 of the Theft Act, but we don't study that. But aggravated burglary carries a maximum sentence of life imprisonment. Start by taking a look at the two burglary offences under section 9. If we start with section 91A, a person commits burglary under section 91A if he enters a building or any part of a building as a trespasser with intent to either steal anything in the building, inflict GBH on any person in the building, or do criminal damage. And this might strike you as a little bit strange because I think the general public tend to think that burglary just means breaking into someone's house and taking stuff. But you can see already from this definition from section 9 that burglary can be that, enter a building and stealing, but it's actually much broader than a lot of people think because it's also including entering a building in order to hurt somebody or cause damage. And you can see here from the definition for section 91A that it's talking about intending to steal, do GBH or do criminal damage. So this means, again, quite surprisingly, that this section is concerned with entry with intent, and under section 91A, there's no need to prove that they actually did in fact manage to steal or do GBH or commit criminal damage. So just going into a building with the intent to do one of those things is enough to be guilty of burglary. Which again, I think is probably going to be quite surprising to a lot of people. If we compare section 91A to section 91B then, a person commits an offence of burglary under section 91B if, having entered as a trespasser, he steals, attempts to steal anything in the building, or inflict or attempts to inflict GBH on any person therein. So the main difference between these two offences of burglary is that under section 91A, the intent must be formed at the time of entry, so before they go in, they intend to do that. Whereas under B, the intent to commit these offences comes later when they're already in the building. And you'll also notice that 91A covers criminal damage, whereas 91B does not. Now, although we have these two different burglary offences, the actus reus of both of these is the same. So that's what we're going to start by looking at. So although 91A and 91B are different crimes, there is the same actus reus for both. So whether it's an A or a B, we must have entry of a building as a trespasser. And whenever you're applying the law on burglary, always talk about the actus reus, check you've got these three elements, and then you can work out whether it's a 91A or a 91B after you've done that. First actus reus requirement for burglary is that we must have entry. And you're probably thinking, well, surely this is obvious if someone's entered the building or not. But actually, over the years, this word entry has posed some problems for the courts. And in the past, it was held that to amount to entry, the defendant had to make a substantial and an effective entry. But this has posed problems in situations like this one in Ryan. So if we have a look at Ryan, our defendant tried to get into a house through a window at 2:30 in the morning, but rather embarrassingly, he got stuck. And his head and right arm was inside the building, but the rest of his body was outside. Now, clearly, this wasn't an effective entry because he's got stuck. So the case of Ryan tweaked and changed the law a little bit on entry. So now entry of a building just means that there is evidence of entry. So basically, as long as part of him was in the building, we had an entry for burglary. Second actus reus requirement for burglary is that we must have entry of a building or part of a building. So again, the courts have had to consider what amounts to a building. And there's no statutory definition of building, although section 9(4) states that inhabited vehicles and vessels are included, even if they're not inhabited at the time of the offence. So let's have a look at some cases then. If we start with B and S and Leithley. In Leithley, we had a lorry container which was resting on sleepers and it was being used as refrigerated storage. And it was connected to the electricity supply and it had been in the same place for 2 to 3 years. And it was held in this case that this outdoor freezer, which was connected to the electricity, was a building for the purposes of the Theft Act, and therefore it was possible to burgle it. And the fact that it was connected to the electricity and it had been in place for 2 or 3 years, so it had this degree of permanence, meant that it was a building. It's always useful to compare this case to the case of Norfolk Constabulary. In this case, a lorry trailer was being used as a storage space outside a supermarket during refurbishment. And this lorry had been in a place for about a year, and there were steps going up into the lorry, but the lorry, importantly, was still on wheels. And it was held that this was not a building for the purposes of the Theft Act, and you couldn't be guilty of burgling it. Now you might be thinking, well, what's the difference? Because this one's also been there for a long time. It too was connected to the electricity. But the key thing is, this was still on wheels. And section 9(4) says that in order for a vehicle to be a building, it has to be inhabited. So because no one was actually living or sleeping in this lorry, and they never had done, it couldn't be a building for the purposes of the Theft Act. Another rather important case on buildings is Rodmell, and I've seen this come up in scenarios before. A garden shed is classed as part of a person's home, so it can be burgled. So your shed in your garden is a building for the purposes of the Theft Act. Actus reus of section 9 burglary also talks about building or part of a building. And entering part of a building was considered in the case of Walkington. Facts in this case were that the defendant was in a Debenhams department store. He saw a till which was partially opened and left unattended. So he reached behind the counter area and looked into the till, but it was empty. He was caught doing this and he was charged with burglary under section 91A for entering a part of a building, i.e., behind the counter, with intent to steal. He was convicted and he appealed, contending that the counter was not physically separated from the rest of the store and couldn't be counted as part of a building. However, his conviction was upheld and there was no requirement to have physical separation. The court said that the counter area was clearly out of bounds to the public, and therefore he was a trespasser in that part of the building. And this is a really important case because it's showing that you might be welcome in a particular room or a particular place in a building, but you're not necessarily welcome in all of it. So if you come into college, you are welcome in the classroom. But there will be storerooms and places like that, or the area behind the teacher's desk. They would be classed as part of a building for burglary, and it would be possible for you to burgle those. Part of the actus reus is that you've got to be sure that your defendant was a trespasser. And here we've got the case of Collins, which is quite an interesting case. So the facts here was that our defendant was charged with burglary. He'd climbed a ladder to an open window where a young woman was sleeping naked in her bed. He descended the ladder, stripped down to his socks, and then he climbed up again. The woman awoke, saw him at the window. She thought it was her boyfriend, so she invited him in. She then proceeded to have sexual intercourse with him. In the middle of this act, she then realised it was not her boyfriend and screamed for him to get off, and he ran away. and the following day he was questioned by the police and charged with burglary under section 91A on the grounds that he'd entered as a trespasser with intent to commit rape. Now, I should point out that in the past, when this case was heard, one of the ulterior offences for 91A was intention to commit rape. That's since been removed, but that's why it's here in this case. The jury convicted him, and then the defendant appealed on the grounds of a misdirection. And his conviction was quashed. And it was held that there must be an effective and substantial entry with knowledge or being reckless as to being a trespasser. And because the girl had invited him in, he was not a trespasser. So this case is telling us that in general, if you're invited in, you are not a trespasser. However, it might be, and this is what we need to consider now, that you are invited in and you start off as being welcome, but you can later become a trespasser if you go beyond permission. With going beyond permission is highlighted in the case of Smith and Jones. And here, our two defendants went to the home of one of the parents and stole two television sets. And they were being prosecuted for burglary because the prosecution was saying, well, you've entered as trespassers and you've stolen these TVs. The dad in the case didn't want his son to be prosecuted, so the dad gave evidence stating that it couldn't be burglary because his son had permission to be in the house, so therefore he wasn't a trespasser. However, the Court of Appeal held that the defendants were guilty of burglary because although they were allowed to be in the house for good reasons, if you like, they'd exceeded their permission by stealing. And therefore, they became trespassers when they took those TVs out of the house. We've looked at the actus reus of burglary then. We need entry of a building or part of a building as a trespasser. Let's have a look at the mens rea. So the mens rea always starts the same. The defendant must know that they're a trespasser or they're being reckless as to whether they are trespassing. And remember that recklessness means that they're taking a risk that they might be trespassing, but they're doing it anyway. And then the mens rea changes slightly depending on whether it's a 91A or a 91B. So 91A requires intention to commit one of the ulterior offences. That means the intention to steal or do GBH or criminal damage. They must have that intention at the time of entry. And for a 91B, the requisite mens rea of the ulterior offence must be present when they're in there. So I'll just give you a little example of each of these. So for a 91A, let's say I think to myself, right, I've got no money, so I'm going to go to Asda and I'm going to steal some milk. And I go into Asda and there's loads of security staff there and I wimp out and I leave. That can be a 91A burglary because although I didn't actually take any milk, when I entered that building, I had intention to steal the milk. In reality, it's going to be very hard to prosecute me for that unless I confess to the police. But technically for a 91A, even if I don't take anything, it can be a 91A. If I go in with the intention to take milk and I get the opportunity and I take the milk, that again is a 91A because I did have the intention at the time I went in. Whereas a 91B I think of as being a bit more opportunistic. So I'm in Asda, I went there, I wasn't intending to steal anything, but I suddenly see, oh, there's hardly any staff in here today. And I put, a cheese in my handbag. So at that point, I'd already entered the building and I stole when I was in there. So we'll just end this video on the summary sheet. So remember, it's defined in section 91A and 91B, the two different types. The actus reus is the same for both, entry of a building or part of a building as a trespasser. And for the mens rea, they must know or be reckless as to whether they're trespassing. And for a 91A, they have intention to do the ulterior offence on entry. And for a 91B, they get the mens rea for theft or GBH once they're already in there.